So this past weekend, Donald Trump nearly died in a plane crash. Or at least that's what some people on social media would want you to think. In reality, Donald Trump was flying over the Gulf of Mexico, which technically is supposed to be a no-fly zone. But either way, Donald Trump's plane suffered an engine failure, had to make an emergency landing in New Orleans, fixed him up, got him home, no problem, right? Well, Donald Trump is never one to miss out on an opportunity to cash in. And so after this news broke this week about Donald Trump's, you know, near-death experience, he sends an email out to his supporters begging them for money to please help me fix my plane. Here's what it says. Do you remember Trump Force One? Before becoming the greatest president of all time, I traveled the country in my plane known as Trump Force One. I have a very important update on my plane, but I need to trust that you won't share it with anyone. My team is building a brand new Trump Force One. And of course, he wants them to give him money to finish building Trump Force One. He also says that the media doesn't know about this, which is bullcrap because the media has been reporting on Donald Trump building a new plane since last year when his current plane also had to make an emergency stop in Nashville after once again suffering engine failure. So Donald Trump's flying around on this old dilapidated plane. Been building a new one for a long time. It's already been widely reported, but he's telling these people, like, listen, just between you and me, I need a new plane and I need you to give me some money for it. And the emails were sent out from one of Donald Trump's political action committees, Save America. And there lies the problem, folks. You see, if this is Donald Trump's personal plane, or if it's a plane that he uses for business, soliciting donations to help pay for it through a political action committee is exceptionally illegal. Or, conversely, if this plane is only so he can go do political things, then the political action committee could pay for it, and then the second he uses it for any business or personal purposes, that becomes exceptionally illegal. And I refuse to believe that Donald Trump is not going to use this plane for both of those things. So no matter which way you slice it, if the political action committee takes in money and uses it to build this plane, that's illegal as soon as he does something he's not supposed to do, either work or politics, depending on which one it is. So why is this not the bigger story, right? Why is this not the thing that people are talking about? You can't just use a political action committee to say, you know what? I think I want a new plane. I want a new jet. I want it top of the line. I want one that's not going to have engine failure anytime you have to fly for more than 30 minutes. I'm just going to start a political action committee and get other people to pay for it. Now, listen to me. If Trump is in fact worth as much as he says he is, which I highly doubt, but if he is, the guy should have no problem whatsoever paying for his own plane, right? That's pocket change. And not to mention the fact that, by the way, the 2017 Republican tax cuts actually included tax breaks for buying a private jet. The state of Florida, where Donald Trump officially lives now, is also working on a tax break for wealthy people who buy private jets, so you'd get that on top of the other one. So Donald Trump could make out like a bandit here and not have to fleece his supporters to buy him a new plane so that he doesn't go down in flames.
This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.